Welcome friends. In this series of lectures, we will discuss the NCERT textbook of history in a short and exam focused manner. We will cover from class 6 to 12th in the upcoming lectures. So please listen to these lectures again and again to reap the maximum benefit. First we will start with this textbook, Themes in Indian History, Part 1, which is a 12th standard NCERT textbook. This theme deals with the Harappan civilization. First, we need to know about the Harappan seals. It is a distinctive artifact of the Harappan civilization. The stone called steatite is used. Mostly steatite is used. And it contains animal motifs, signs, and the script on these stones are undeciphered till yet. We need to know this, that the script is undeciphered. This looks like a Harappan seal. You can see the animal motif. This is the script here. And this, I don't know, and this is some kind of a sign, still undeciphered. Also in this page, we see that the term culture is defined. It is a very good definition. Here, culture is defined as a group of objects distinctive in style, usually found together within a specific geographical area and a period of time. So in case of Harappan culture, these objects are seals, beads, weight, stone, plate, and even baked bricks. These objects are found in areas like Afghanistan, Jammu, Balochistan, and Gujarat. There's a big area. So people get confused about between Harappan civilization and Indus Valley civilization, Mohenjo-Daro civilization. See, these all are the same. It is named after this Harappa, which was the first site which was discovered. This civilization is dated between 2600 and 1900 BCE. Only because Harappa was the first site discovered, it is called Harappan civilization. The other names are Indus Valley civilization or Mohenjo-Daro civilization. Here we can see these beads, these are blades, these are weights, different. The next page shows us the area under the important Harappan sites. So we already know about Harappa, Mohenjo-Daro, Dholavira, Lothal, Kalibangan, Rakhigadi. These are important sites, but you should have a idea on which site is where. Mostly, you know, rivers like Mohenjo-Daro, you can see it is on Indus River, Harappa on Ravi River, Kalibangan, Banavali, all these rivers. You can have a vague outlook like Sabarmati River, Lothal. You should go deep into these maps. Here is where the question arises. Also, what you need to know is from which site what was discovered. Some major things which were discovered, which we shall discuss in this coming time. The Harappans followed a subsistence strategies. They ate wide variety of plant and animal products, which also included fish. These dietary practices have been founded by archaeobotanists. They used charred grains and seeds to understand this cultural aspect. The grains which were found in Harappan civilization were wheat, barley, lentils, chickpea, and sesame. Also, millets were found in some sites in Gujarat. And the animal bones which were found were cattle, sheep, goat, buffalo, and pig. These were studied by archaeozoologists. Archaeozoologists also indicate that these cattle, sheep, goat, buffalo, and pig were domesticated. Also, some bones of wild species like boar, deer, and gharial were found. There is a confusion regarding Harappans, whether they hunted these animals themselves or they obtained the meat from other hunting communities. Bones of fish and fowl are also found. In case of agricultural technology, On seals and terracotta sculpture, bull was known. This from this archaeologists extrapolated that oxen was used for ploughing. The terracotta models of plough also have been found in Cholistan and Banavali, Haryana. A ploughed field at Kalibangan, Rajasthan. Here, the two sets of furrows at right angle to each other were found, suggesting that two different crops were grown together. In case of irrigation, the traces of canals have been found at Harappan sites of Shortugai and Afghanistan, but these canals are not found in Punjab or Sindh. This is the terracotta bull we were speaking about from Cholistan and Banavali. Regarding, see this map, these are the areas of early Harappan occupation. Just four, if you remember, it'll be easy to solve answers. Siswal, Kot Tiji, Damsadat, and Amrinal. In the last page, we said read about the mature Harappan sites. See, mostly the area is same. It is mentioned here also. The settlements generally small. There were virtually no large buildings. There was a break between early Harappan and Harappan civilization. But the sites were almost the same. Continuing in the agricultural technologies, we see that in Dholavira, a big water reservoir was found. Here you can see the reservoir at the Dholavira. It is huge. And here, processing of food was also done, not only just agriculture, like mixing, blending, and cooking. The grinding equipment were made out of stone, metal, terracotta. One example is the saddle quern. Saddle quern, here you can see. It is like chakki, just map atta piece too. So their bases are usually convex. These are set in the earth in the mud to prevent their rocking. So the stone will go on this. And to and fro motion, say we can easily grind the grains. Next, we come to Mohenjo-Daro. Mohenjo-Daro is the most well-known site of this Indus Valley civilization. This settlement is divided into two sections. One is smaller but higher, and the other is much larger but lower. Here we can see the higher one is called the citadel, and the lower one is called the lower town. The citadel is built on a platform. Platform made of this platform is raised by mud. All the important buildings, it is assumed that they were a part of the citadel. Both the citadel and the lower town, they were walled, that means separated from each other. This organized planning, organized construction of these cities show that they were well planned before they were constructed. Well planned. The other signs by which we can know that this city was well planned is by their bricks. Their bricks were of uniform ratio. Here we can see in the next page it is written that the length and breadth were four times and twice the height of these sun-dried or baked bricks. Here, Alexander Cunningham, the first Director General of ASI, who is also the father of Indian archaeology, he said that Harappa was the first site to be discovered, but it was badly destroyed by big robbers. He also mentioned that the amount of bricks taken from this ancient site was enough to lay bricks for about 100 miles of the railway line between Lahore and Multan. So he said that Mohenjo-Daro was far better preserved to understand this culture. The most distinctive features of this Harappan city, that is the carefully planned drainage system, can be beautifully observed in this Mohenjo-Daro. This is a drain, just imagine. Here the streets with drains were laid out first and then the houses were built along them. Also, the domestic wastewater had to flow into the street drains, and every house needed to have at least one wall along a street. In the lower town, you can observe that the roads and streets were laid out in an approximate grid pattern, like this. So it was easier to construct houses along them. Here we see the residential buildings found in Mohenjo-daro. It is said that mainly there was a central courtyard with rooms on all sides. Here we can see the courtyard. The screen is courtyard with rooms on all sides. Courtyard is the place where it is assumed that major activities like weaving and cooking was done. Here we can see the staircases. Staircases assume that the house were not single-storied, they might have been double-storied. One thing to observe is that the entrance of this house, the important feature of the entrances was that it does not give the interior view or of the house or the courtyard. Also, a thing to be noticed is there is no window. There are no windows in the walls along the ground level, so it gives a concern for the privacy. Every house had its own bathroom, and bathroom was paved with bricks with drains connected to the walls through the street drains. So now also every house does not have a bathroom. As you know, Swachh Bharat Mission. People had bathrooms 2,000 years ago. Next, we come to the citadel of Mohenjo-daro. As we already know, citadel is made on an upraised platform. It consists of structures for special purpose. Now, what these structures are? These include the warehouse, the great bath, and various other structures which you can see. We'll discuss the most important ones. Warehouse. Warehouse is a building used to store the storage used to store goods. Then the great bath. Great bath, you can see here. This is the great bath. It is a rectangular tank in a courtyard surrounded by corridor on four sides. There are two flights of steps to north and south. It's not much important. The most important thing is this great bath. It was made watertight using a mortar of gypsum. There were rooms on three sides, one in which was a large well. Water from the tank flowed into the huge drain. So this was the drainage of the tank. Another thing to note that there were proper bathrooms inside the building complex of Great Bath. Other important buildings in the citadel were this stupa area, the great courtyard. There was a college, an excavated well. Jensen excavated, so it is called Jensen's excavated well. Then one is a pillared hall. There are trenches, Marshall's deep trench, Wheeler's deep trench. This is the warehouse. Stairs. This whole citadel is fortified. There are walls surrounding the whole citadel. To understand the social and economic differences among the people living in a particular culture, there are several methods. First is to study the burials. As you know, in Egypt also, some pyramids were royal burial, where enormous quantities of wealth was buried. In Harappan civilization also, we have noticed that some were just hollowed out spaces lined with bricks. Some graves contained pottery and ornaments that it might be a belief that they can be used in the afterlife. Also, in some graves, it has been found that jewelry is present, jewelry in both men and women. In Harappa, there is one grave in which the skull of male, near to the skull of male, jewelry is present. In many instances, the dead were buried with copper mirror. This copper mirror was present. And it was assumed that Harappans did not believed in burying precious things with the dead. Another thing to look for in social differences is luxuries. Luxuries means studying the artifacts. The artifacts can be either utilitarian or luxurious. So the daily use artifacts were made out of stone or clay, that is easily available material like quartz, pottery, needle, flesh rubbers, etc. And if the मटेरियल वॉज मेड आउट ऑफ नॉन लोकल और विद कॉम्प्लिकेटेड टेक्नोलॉजीज. इट वॉज अ लग्जूरियस मटेरियल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लिटिल पॉट्स ऑफ फायंस. दिस फायंस इज अ मटेरियल मेड आउट ऑफ ग्राउंड सैंड और सिलिका मिक्सड विद कलर एंड गम एंड देन फायर्ड. सो यू कैन सी इट इज़ अ वेरी टेक्निकल, इट्स अ वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड टेक्नोलॉजी. नॉट एवरीबडी कैन अफोर्ड दिस. If we generally study the distribution of such artifacts, we find that the rare objects made out of valuable material, they are generally concentrated in the large settlements like Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa, and are rarely found in settlements which are small. For example, this miniature pots of faience, these were maybe used as perfume bottles. They are found mostly in Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa, but we cannot retrieve even one from Kalibangan. Also, gold is assumed to be very rare because it was recovered from hoards. Hoards are objects kept carefully by people in often inside containers such as pot. It's like khopche mein jo chupa karke rakhte hain. Craft production in IBC cannot be left unmentioned. This small tiny settlement called Chanhodaro, which is said to be less than even 7 hectares as compared to Mohenjo-Daro, which is 125 hectares. This settlement was exclusively devoted to craft production, that is bead making, shell cutting, metal working, seal making and weight making. The beads were very beautiful. They were made out of stone like carnelian, which gives a red color, jasper, crystal, quartz, steatite. Sometimes beads were made out of metals like copper, bronze and gold, even using shell, faience, terracotta and burnt clay. They were found in numerous shapes, disc shaped, cylindrical, spherical, barrel shaped and segmented. Some were even decorated by incising or painting, and some had designs etched onto them. Techniques of making the beads differed generally according to the material, but generally it was that nodules, they were chipped into rough shapes, then finally flaked into the final form. After flaking, they were grinded, polished, and drilling was done. Also, specialized drills have been recovered from Chanhodaro, Lothal, and Dholavira. These two settlements, Nageshwar and Balakot, they were found near the coast. So there was specialized center for making shell objects like bangles, ladles and inlays, and these were also taken to other settlements like Mohenjo-Daro and Harappa. Also, to understand the centers of production, we take into note the raw material, like the place where maximum raw material is found, where it is closer to maybe a copper ore, close to the sea. If the tools are found, unfinished objects, rejects and waste material, these can be used to find where the artifact was actually produced. For this craft production, many material had to be procured from the outside, like stone, timber and metal. Also, there have been terracotta toys, model of bullock cart, suggesting that this could have been one of the important means of transporting goods and people across the land routes. Riverine routes along the Indus and its tributary were also probably used. The far-off sites from where the raw material was procured is like Shortugai. It is in far-off Afghanistan, which is the best source of lapis lazuli. It is a blue stone. It is very highly valued. And Lothal was close to the source of carnelian, that is Bharuch and Gujarat. Steatite from South Rajasthan and North Gujarat, and metal from Rajasthan. Also, they sent expedition to areas such as Khetri region of Rajasthan for copper and South India for gold. Occasional findings of Harappan artifacts at these places, they have led to this assumption. Also, there was another non-Harappan culture, Ganeshwar Jodhpura culture in Khetri area. It is not connected to Harappa. It has non-Harappan pottery, a different kind of copper objects are found there. But it is possible that the inhabitants of this region supplied copper to the Harappans. The Harappans not only traded in India, but their trade was widespread. Like we can see their trade with Magan, that is Oman, Mesopotamia. It is assumed that Magan was the producer of copper and Harappan civilization took copper from this Omanian region, as both have found traces of nickel. Also, a big Harappan jar has been found in this Oman region. Mesopotamian text also mention about a place called Magan. The same copper with the traces of nickel is found in this area as well. In the Mesopotamian text, the Indus Valley civilization is also called as Meluha. It is mentioned in the text that they procured carnelian, lapis lazuli, copper, gold, and varieties of wood from this place called Meluha, which is the Indus Valley civilization. This is a cylindrical seal. It is typically found in Mesopotamia. But as you can see, this humped bowl. This hump-pull motif is derived from the Indus region. This circular Persian Gulf seal, it is found in Bahrain. It contains Harappan motifs sometimes. Also, it is important to note here that the Dilmun weights, they followed the Harappan standard. And here we can see a seal which contains a boat, which shows us that it was likely that communication with Oman, Bahrain and Mesopotamia this occurred by the sea. Next to be read are the seal scripts and weights. Now, what is a seal sealing? The seals and sealings were used to facilitate long distance communication. These will check that if the package we are sending, it has been tampered with or not. The package will be tied with a rope and on the knot will be affixed some wet clay on which one or more seals were pressed, leaving an impression. If the bag reached with the sealing intact, it meant that it had not been tampered with. About this Harappan script, these inscriptions were short. Till date, the Harappan script is undeciphered, and the only thing we know that it is not alphabetical, as there are too many signs, about 375 to 400 signs. And also the other name for the script is called Boustrophedon script. It will, person will start writing like this, that is from left to right, then right to left, then left to right, again right to left. This is called a Boustrophedon script. And well, Harappans were very organized in nature. They used to write on everything. Seals, copper tools, rims of jar, copper, terracotta tablets, even jewelry, bone rods, and there was even an ancient signboard. You see, this is the ancient signboard. Exchanges in Harappan time were regulated by precise system of weight. These were usually made out of stone called chert. They were cubical with no markings. As we saw in page 1, these are the weights. The lower denomination of these weights were binary, while the higher denomination followed a decimal system. It is assumed that the smaller weights were used for weighing jewelry and beads. Metal scale pans have also been found. This is a metal scale pan. It is till date used by us. We can commonly see it with the vegetable vendors. Regarding the authority of this Harappan society, there are indications that these complex decisions like uniform pottery, seals, weights, bricks, these could not have been taken if there was not a uniform system of authority. For example, we can see the bricks, they were not produced in one single center, but they were of uniform ratio throughout the region, that is from Jammu to Gujarat. And also we've seen that there were settlements strategically set up in specific locations for various reasons. Regarding the center of power, there were merit theories. In Mohenjo-daro, this priest king sculpture was found. This statue, priest king, is assumed to be king. As in Mesopotamian history, the priest king is mentioned many times. Another school of thought was of the opinion that Harappan society had no rulers and that everybody enjoyed single status. It is countered by another theory, which feels that there was no single ruler, but several. They assumed that there was a single state. There is similarity in artifacts, planned settlement, standardized ratio of brick size, and establishment of settlement near raw sources. So this means that there was a single state, but not a single ruler, but several rulers. Also, there is a theory, which is most unlikely, that the entire community collectively made and implemented these complex decisions. Near to about 1900 BC, the Harappan artifacts started disappearing, like weight, seal, beads, writing, trade, craft specialization. All these started disappearing. So this was termed as the decline of IBC. Many theories have been put regarding the reasons for decline of IBC. They range from climate change, deforestation, excessive floods, shifting or drying up of rivers, overuse of landscape, even foreign invasions. Thus, by about 1800 BC, the IBC had declined significantly. So we have read a lot about Harappan civilization, but do you know how this Harappan civilization was discovered? When Harappan cities fell into the ruin, people gradually forgot all about the Harappan cities. But after about a millennium, people, when they would see strange artifacts that were occasionally surfaced, washed by floods or explored by soil erosion, or maybe turned up while plowing a field or digging for treasure, people would be very confused. As so was the first Director General of ASI, Alexander Cunningham. During Cunningham's time, archaeologists preferred to use the written word, that is text and inscription, as a guide to investigation. Mainly Cunningham used the accounts left by Chinese Buddhist pilgrims who had visited the subcontinent between 4th and 7th century to locate the early settlement. The site like Harappa, it was not an itinerary of Chinese pilgrims. It was not known as an early historic city. So although Harappan artifacts were found fairly often, these were not taken up very seriously by Cunningham. He was unable to successfully place it within the time frame with which he was familiar with. From exam point of view, it is only important to note that first time Harappa was discovered by Dayaram Sahni, Mohenjo-daro by Rakhal Das Banerjee. Finally, in 1924, John Marshall, the Director General of ASI, he announced the discovery of a new civilization in the Indus Valley to the world. Reconstructing religious practices was one of the most difficult problem for the archaeologist. Early archaeologists, they thought that certain objects which seemed unusual or unfamiliar may have a religious significance, like terracotta figurines of women, heavily jeweled, some with elaborate headdress, like this mother goddess, we can see. Some rare stone statuary of men in a standardized posture, seated with one hand on the knee. He was called the priest king. Also, some structures have been assigned ritual significance, like the great bath and fire altars found in Kalibangan and Lothal. Also, seals have been used to reconstruct the religious belief, some of which they seem to depict a ritual scene. Some animals, like one-horned animal, often called the unicorn, it is depicted on the seal. It seems to be a mythical and composite creature. In some seals, a cross-legged, in a yogic posture, surrounded by animals, a man is found. He is called as Proto-Shiva. In some seals, conical object are also found, seals in the form of cone, which were classified as lingas. Many reconstructions of the Harappan religion are made on the assumption that later traditions provide parallel with the earlier ones. For example, let us look at this Proto-Shivasil. The earliest religious text, the Rig Veda, mentions a god name called Rudra, which is a name used for Shiva in later Puranic tradition. However, unlike Shiva, Rudra in the Rig Veda is neither depicted as Pashupati nor as Yogi. It was then later suggested that it was possibly a shaman. Shamans are men or women who possibly claim to have magical powers, who can connect to other worlds. This is a proto-Shiva seal. You can see the animals, the cross-legged man with horns. After so many decades of archaeological work, we have a fairly good idea of the Harappan economy, but still many questions remained unanswered. Like, was Great Bath a ritual structure? How widespread was literacy? Do Harappan cemeteries show little social differentiation? Also, unanswered questions on gender, like, did women make pottery or they paint pots? What were the other craft person? All these questions still archaeologists are pondering upon. This brings us to the end of theme 1. Please go through these tables.